So I made a deal with the shadowy figure over in the corner. Go, you can show him. I'm going, you. Yes. That's Michael. He sits over there. He judges me. And I made a deal with Michael. He said, "You, I bet you can't do a whole show without cussing." And I was like, "Ooh la la!" Yeah. Oh, well, there goes my dollar. Do you think we could do a whole show without cussing?
No. No.
Yeah. No, I see, I think that the problem is, you see, that what I think is slang, other people think is cussing. I don't know if you can see this at home. Well, I know you can't, but there are people in the audience going, mm-hmm. It's because they're on heroin. That happens a lot when you're on heroin, and you kind of go, and you agree with utter nonsense. For example, slang words and cuss words are different. Slang words are words like flip-flop. Is that a slang word? Or maybe, what's another slang word, Jeff?
Sheboygan.
Yeah, good one, Sheboygan. What about, spumply? I made it up. That's a made up, that's a different version. So you get a made up word, a slang word, and a cuss word. Made up word, spumply. Slang word, Sheboygan. Cuss word,
ay caramba!
Very simple. Right, Jeff?
Yeah, that sounds about right.
It's about right. Now, I'll tell you one thing that, that I know. What's the one thing I should tell him?
Hell if I know.
I'll tell him one thing. I know a bunch of things, but what one thing do you think I should tell him?
Well, the one thing is always wear a different necktie for each day of the week.
Well, that's what I do. Why do I do that? Because I live large. I live every day like it's another day. You hear that sound? That's the sound of an audience getting uncomfortable. I live for that sound. That's when I know we're beginning to push the boundaries of this thing. Right about now, every atom in my body is saying, throw to commercial, and I'm like, not yet. Not yet. I'm gonna make you wait. Naughty, you can't clap your way out of this. Go on, you can't stand it. Hit the clicker. I don't give a crikey. And now, for those of you who waited,
sponsored by Capital One Venture Card. What's in your wallet? Ladies and gentlemen, Craig Ferguson.
Thank you, that's enough. You've so inspired me with your genuine applause and love. And I'm going to do my best to be entertaining. In a break from tradition with this show, I'm going to even try tonight. Doo-dee-doo, doo-dee-doo. Doo-doo-doo, doo-dee-doo-doo. Doo-doo-doo, doo-dee-doo-doo. That's the kind of cross between the Beatles and Frank Sinatra right there, isn't it? Doo-dee-doo, doo-dee-doo. Doo-doo-doo, doo-dee-doo. Rooty-toot, doo-dee-doo-toot. Well, thanks, everybody. I don't know. I hate it when applause is started by the warm-up comedian. Then I think, oh, genuine applause. And then I see him going, eh, to everybody. Makes me sad and happy at the same time. I'm conflicted. Am I? No, kind of. It's a great day for America, everybody. You know why? I'll tell you why it's a great day, because it's Boy Scout Day. Yes! This is the big day if you're a Boy Scout. The Boy Scouts, of course, were founded 102 years ago this very day. So to all you Boy Scouts out there, the Nanu Nanu. Now, whatever it is that you say, I don't know. Shazbat. The real Boy Scout slogan, of course, is do a good turn daily, which is kind of vague. Well, I mean, do a good turn, what does it mean? Do it like this? I think I just got a merit badge in fierce. I was briefly a member of the Boy Scouts when I was about 10 years old. My dad signed me up. He said that the Boy Scouts would be something for us to share together. He dropped me off at a meeting and he said, let me know how it goes. Oh, laugh at my pain. In Scotland, the Scoutmasters had the exact same uniforms as the boys. You know, the same shorts, the same badges, the same canteen full of whiskey. I went to a Boy Scout camp. The short time I was there, I went to a place called Windy Ridge. And we were sleeping in sleeping bags, and it was so cold, and I was a little nervous, and I'd never been away from home before. I peed my sleeping bag. But this is true. This is a completely true story. And the weird twist of fate, the pee escaped from my sleeping bag. I don't want to be too graphic about it, but the pee landed on the sleeping bag of the boy sleeping next to me in the tent. So it would appear that he had peed his sleeping bag when I knew all the time it was me. So when I woke up, I did what any Boy Scout would do. I blamed him for being at himself. And for the rest of the trip, everyone called him Mr. Peabody. I know, and then years later, I won the Peabody Award for talking to Desmond Tutu about doing the right thing even when no one is looking. It's so ironic! That's true! And I often wonder what happened to the guy I blamed for peeing. I hope he wasn't scarred by the event. I'm sure it turned out fine. What was his name again? Oh, yeah, Gerard Depardieu. Because that... Gerard Depardieu was a very popular name in Scotland in the 1970s. Another Gerard Depardieu, that's four in this class already. Anyway, the Scouts in Britain, we used to do something called Bob a Job. I'm telling you, that's true. A bob was a shilling, it was about 10 cents. You go from door to door and do a small job and they give you a bob. Look it up, buddy. I'm telling the truth. That's all I'm saying. Then the homeowner, you give the homeowner a sticker that said, job done. And we do all sorts of jobs, cleaning, painting, landscaping. We were like immigrants, but free. Or a bob. I miss those Bob a Job days. Oh, there's a place in West Hollywood where a guy named Bob will pay you for a job. But it's not the same. It's better. Respect the Boy Scouts, though. They teach young men many skills that come in handy later in life. Water safety, first aid, unthinking obedience to all forms of authority. It teaches you outdoor survival skills that will make you, you know, young men successful later if they decide to become explorers or hobos. Many of the skills the Boy Scouts learn come from the Native Americans. That's why so many Scouts grow up to run gambling casinos. What the hell, man?
Oh, man.
Yeah.
What's wrong with you people?
Yeah.
Pick up the energy a little bit, will you?
You know what this is like? It's like trying to start a fire by rubbing two sticks together.
I think they call that jerk a work.
Jerk a work?
Yeah, instead of Baba Job, it's called jerk.
Oh, that's your thing? You made that thing up from Baba Job? Baba Job's a real thing.
Yeah, so's jerk a work.
No, it's. You made it up. It's a made-up thing. You were never in the Scouts. I was in the Scouts, Nanu Shazbat. You were.
Oh, man, that was rough.
What do you mean, what was rough? What was rough about it? Hey, I'm being indignant for comedic reasons. Why?
You were in the Scouts. I was in the Scouts.
Hey! Did you do a Scottish accent there?
Yeah, I did a Scottish accent. Oh, sure, I did.
Hey!
Oh, here's
all right,
the new
all right,
boy.
All right. All right, you talk like me, and I'll talk like you.
Okay, great, let's do it. Oh, look, it's a great day for America. Hey, Jeff, who's the new boy in class? His name's Gerard Depardieu.
I think this is great. I don't know why people don't love this. If that came on my TV, I'd be entertained.
Balls.
That was awesome, man.
I can't do your eyes, though. The eyes are the hard part.
That's okay. I can't move both arms.
Then how do you do jerka work? That should be our new thing. Like, you know, we could make money doing commercials. We should do commercials. And we'll do, we'll say, like, come to our car dealership and we'll sell you cars. Or, hey, buy our boner pills. Do you have trouble getting a boner? Well, we've got something for you. Yeah, yeah, that's good. Add that little bit. I'll do da-da-da and you do the little mouth organ bit, right?
Yeah.
Now, this is quality television, right? This is the kind of thing that's lacking in television. I mean, what have you got in television now? Homeland and, that show? What I'm saying is it was a good show. What's the other good show on TV?
The Kardashians.
Oh, it's commercial time. This is the time you were like, oh, do the commercials. Do the thing, Jeff.
Sure. You're right. Watching The Late Late Show, where our slogan is, if the jokes aren't funny, we'll just pee on the robot.
Word in. Welcome back to the show where we're really trying tonight, right, Jeff?
Yeah.
For example, my first guest is an Emmy-winning actress. Oh, you know what? Too little, too.
Uh-oh.
She stars in Up All Night, which is Thursdays on NBC. Take a look at this. Please welcome the lovely Christina Applegate, everybody. Christina Applegate.
Hello.
look sensational. Just so lovely.
Thank you very much.
You do look nice. Yes, well done.
As do you. Except your tie's crooked.
Oh, really?
Let's fix that.
Yeah, let's get that thing sorted out.
It's a lost cause.
Why is it not a lot? It's just it leans to one side.
Ba-dum-bum.
Yeah. Were you ever in the Boy Scouts? It's Boy Scouts.
No.
What are you doing there?
I was looking for my penis to be in the Boy Scouts. I was a brownie for a minute.
Really?
Yeah, I was a brownie.
What happened?
I was kicked out for cussing.
Yeah. See, that's the kind of guest I like. Somebody who knows the value of a cuss word.
Yeah, and brownies are a lot younger. They're about 5. You know, you're about 5 years old, 6 years old.
What did you say?
You know, I said...
Tutsi frutsi.
I said ass.
I thought you could say ass here.
And I said another word that I won't say here.
Well, could you?
I'm going to tell you this. It has a C in it.
Oh, boy. That's enough. That's enough. Don't.
There's a couple of K's. And and an R.
Another one I thought it was.
And I got kicked out.
Well, yeah, I mean, because it's the brownies. Where did you hear those words at 5 years old?
I learned them in nursery school.
You don't use them anymore, though, do you?
Every day.
Really? Are you a cussy person?
No. Now that I have a child, you know, it's
well, see, that's the thing. But my oldest boy is 10. He has a tariff on the refrigerator door. If ever I cuss, I have to pay him.
Yeah. I know, it's really hard, because now my daughter's a sponge right now, and
Your daughter's a sponge? That must
be... She is. It happened overnight. It happened overnight. It was so bizarre. I went in there, and it was just all... She was all pilly and weird. No, she just, like, inhaled everything.
I thought you'd adopted her from some aquarium.
Yeah.
You know, that.
SpongeBob SquarePants came over.
That's right.
And had
I don't know why I find that so funny.
I don't know either.
The idea.
It's not one of our best moments.
I don't know. The idea of adopting a sea creature and then watching people in Hollywood try to deal with it, I think it'd be great. This is my daughter. She's a sponge.
Ring. Yeah. So I'm afraid to cuss in front of her because she tries to imitate.
No. No. What age is she?
Yeah, she's a year.
Oh, yeah. My youngest boy's a year old. You getting any sleep?
Congratulations. Yeah, my kid sleeps 12 hours through the night.
What's that coming to go?
That's right.
The hell?
No, you know what?
Sacré bleu. Hey! That's what I'm talking about. Yeah, that kind of language will get you kicked out the brownies around here. So you never joined the Girl Scouts?
I'm on a show about babies.
Was it?
I'm cussing like this.
No, it's all right. Very few babies watch this show.
Very few. I do agree. And we do cuss on that show, so.
Oh, yeah. Cuss. On your show, yeah.
Yeah, we cuss all the time.
What time is it on at, though?
9:30.
Yeah, you can cuss at 9:30.
We're cussing at 8 when we were on Wednesdays. We're cussing.
What the hell? How come you can do that, and then I'm on at 4 o'clock in the morning, and I can't even say, smorgasbord.
We said all sorts of stuff. Yeah. Maybe you should come on over to
NBC. That's been tried before with men that do my kind of thing. Didn't really work out that well.
Oh, now.
No, I'm just saying. So what's going on then?
I didn't mean that, bosses.
No, but, no, don't worry. No, they don't watch this.
What's going on? I don't know. Not much.
You don't have any plans for Boy Scout Day? You don't normally celebrate.
It was Boy Scout
what's
Day?
The big holiday in your house then?
Birthdays.
Right.
You know,
okay.
Normal things.
Normal things.
Watching Castle.
You watch Castle?
I do.
I.
So there's that.
Yeah.
That's all the excitement in our life.
Have you ever been to a castle?
I have.
Which castle?
I don't remember. But
were you very drunk?
It was large and it was cold, and no, I was not drunk.
Okay.
But it was, you know.
Was it in Scotland?
No, it was not. It was in England somewhere. I don't know.
A large cold castle in England?
Mm-hmm.
I think I've been there.
You have?
Yeah, I think I may have been there.
I think it was on a hill.
Yeah, it was on a hill.
Okay.
Looks like in olden times it may have been a strategically easy place to defend.
Yeah.
Yeah, I've definitely been there.
Okay, oh my God!
That's amazing.
I've also been to a castle on a hill in France.
That's a chateau you're talking about right there.
Okay.
Yeah.
It seemed a lot like a castle.
Well, it might have been a castle, you know. I mean, I don't know. They had castles, too, back in the day. The French. I don't know if they did. They did. Of course they did.
Yeah.
Yeah. Were you ever into archery?
What?
Tootsie frootsie. Made you cuss.
You're like, what?
Tutti frutti.
Yeah. Did you ever?
What's with the horse backstage?
What horse are you talking about? Who's on the door?
I didn't mean the horse.
Yeah.
I said the whores backstage. There's a ton of whores backstage.
Yeah, yeah.
But if
well, they
you
like
want,
hanging around
if you
the
want
horse.
The horse to come out, then
yeah.
That's good too.
It's a completely different
it's not
musical
what I said,
intro.
But that's okay. Yeah.
The horse backstage.
That was more like bound to come out.
Yeah.
That's pretty good music. Are you a musical person?
Sure. Why not? I was in a Broadway show.
That's true.
And it had, that's true. Yeah. You know, I sang, I danced.
What about playing a musical instrument? The harp.
No.
You play the harp?
No.
Well, with all the archery, it's kind of the same.
Yeah, no, I've never played the harp.
Or been involved in archery?
No.
Why not?
Dude, I grew up in L.A. We don't do, and we say dude here a lot. It's not a lot of archery.
I've lived in L.A. now for 17 years. I've only said dude like 5 times.
Yeah. I say dude a lot.
Do you really?
It upsets me.
Well, stop saying it.
Okay. Maybe I will.
It's hard, though.
It's really hard to say dude.
Same problem with whiskey.
Drinking it or saying the word whiskey?
Well, I would say the word in bars.
Yeah.
And like, I won't get to a bar and say whiskey, and they'd say, okay.
There you go.
Or I'd walk into the bar and say whiskey, and they go, no, you were the guy who was here last night. No whiskey for you.
Yeah.
You go.
There you go.
But you don't have a problem with alcohol, do you?
No.
Anymore?
I don't have a problem with alcohol anymore.
Anymore.
Not today.
Yay, yay, yay. Well, I don't like the idea of you getting all liquored up and then firing arrows around the L.A. I don't know why. I've just decided you're...
You decided I do archery?
Yeah. Why not?
Is that an archerist? Wait a minute. What would you call it? An archer?
A bow lady.
A bow lady?
Bow lady. Bow lady. It sounds
no
like
archery for me.
No archery?
Throwing darts? Is that close enough?
What? No.
Is someone going to win a prize if I admit to archery? Is that why you keep asking me about it? It's like I say archery and all of a sudden balloons come down and someone
you,
wins a prize.
You got the wrong
Asphalt joke.
Wait a minute.
I mean, a balloon, maybe,
I'm
if I blew
Oprah
it up.
Right now.
No, this is not Oprah.
Damn it.
No, it ain't. Can we, we have to take a break and then do the thing? All right, we have
okay.
to take a break. Do you want to do this? It's entertainment. Look, with America's fit. Whoa, hey. Well, you got an arrow between the eyes up there. Wow.
Don't forget, I'm a bow lady.
Yeah. Welcome back, everybody. I'm here with America's favorite bow lady. Wow.
See?
They're kicking them out.
Oh, that's so sad.
Yeah. They'll rough them up outside, isn't
wow.
it? Yeah,
you
they do that to me.
Rules.
I have to pay extra for
you
it.
You have tight rules up in here. Yeah, you can cuss like a drunken sailor up here, but yet one guy's like, whoa, I love you.
Yeah. One girl. One girl.
Wow.
Is that what he said?
That
I don't know if that's what he
said. That is re-off, I have to say.
I don't know if he said I love you to you or I love you to me.
He just mentioned a character I used to play on this show a long time ago.
Yeah, I remember that show.
Yeah.
I saw that show.
Did you see that show?
I saw you in that show.
I was young.
Oh, yeah.
Don't forget, for most of that show, I was under the age of 18. So, just... Must remind people of that so often.
I get it.
I was a mere child.
Can you throw me out, please? I think you probably... Yeah. All right, so we're done here, but...
Is it something I said?
Yeah, yeah. I wanted to talk to you more about archery, but we just don't have the time. So, listen, you have to choose awkward pause...
Okay.
...or mouth organ... ...or a big cash prize.
Big cash prize.
Why did you say it like that?
Because that's the only one that I'm interested in having right now.
Yeah, but you didn't say big cash prize.
Your options are very enticing over here.
All right, that mouth organ, poo in your hair, or big cash prize.
Big cash prize.
You don't want poo in your hair?
No.
All right, a lot of people like that.
That's not my problem.
All right, man. What time is the Shadow Stamer?
Time for the big cash.
See that?
Yeah.
You see that? Like the money was going to go off, and then
I moved.
Because
you've been practicing that.
Yeah, well, but not with this hand. I always use this hand.
Okay, there you go. Oh, God.
No, like that. For archery.
Okay.
All right, there are two ways to win the big cash prize, $50. You can use it, you know, in stores. You can either answer the question, or you can guess what's in my box. What happens there is I imagine a box in my head. I don't know what's in it. Jeff is the only person who knows what's in the box. You guess what's in the box. If you're right, Jeff will tell us, and you walk away with $50. If you're wrong, you're wrong.
And what's the other question?
Well, it could be a question that I choose out of this array of questions.
It's not like science questions or anything, right? Is that like hard?
Yeah, there might be a couple of science questions in you.
I mean, I am a blonde, you know.
No. That's, I don't believe in that.
All right, I'm gonna guess what's in your box.
Okay.
All right, so I just say what I think is...
Wait, I've got to imagine the box.
Okay, all right, sorry.
I've got to imagine the box, and then Jeff's got to know what's inside. It involves some telepathy.
Sorry,
do you believe this?
Just slow down there,
yeah,
sister.
Slow down, lady. Slow down.
Okay, okay.
Take your time.
Okay, okay, I got
you
it.
No, I'm waiting. A little bit of kissing first. All right, you ready, Jeff?
I'm ready.
All right. I'm imagining a box, but I don't know what's in it. All right, it's a box. I've imagined it.
Okay.
It's pretty big.
How big? Do I get to ask questions?
Yeah, why not?
How big is it?
Wait. You're going to ask him like that? What the hell, like, how big is it? Like, what the hell? You're making fun of me now. How big is it in this crappy show where guys get thrown out of the audience and everything?
How big's the box?
It's about the size of a bread box.
A bread box. Okay.
Yeah, it's about the size of a bread box.
So now I guess.
If you want, yeah. Take your time. There's not much going on here.
Okay. I think that in that box is the discarded skin of a snake.
Well, I don't know if that's true. We have to go to Jeff and find out. Jeff, what is in the box?
Discarded skin of a snake is correct, baby.
Easy, I can have you thrown out. Do you believe that?
It's unbelievable.
Unbelievable.
Man.
I was like, they're throwing him out. I mean, all he did was yell. I do that the whole show.
I keep wishing to get thrown out.
Yeah, me too. I'm like, come on. Oh, let get me out of here. Pepper spray me in the groin.
Ooh.
My next guest is in a show called It's a Brad World, which is on Mondays on Bravo. Take a look at this. Please welcome Brad Goreski, everybody. Brad Goreski. Brad, how great to see you. You look sensational.
sensational, but I would have expected nothing less.
Well, thank you very much.
You are the most fabulous Canadian I've ever met.
Thank you. There are quite a few fabulous Canadians now.
Are there? William Shatner.
Celine Dion.
Never mention her here.
Why?
I'd rather not say.
What happened?
Look, don't ask me again or I'll have you thrown out.
To go join that other guy.
Well, I really like your. Are they slippers or shoes?
They're shoes.
Yeah, they're very nice.
Thanks.
And they've got. They're Christian Louboutin. I went to his store when I was in Paris.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, yeah, and he had those in the store.
Yeah, they're really good, except they almost got confiscated by airport security today.
They do look a bit weapony.
I was like, no, 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 I have to wear them on the Craig Ferguson show tonight. Please, please. And now, look, they're here.
And that worked?
Canadian pleading, yes.
Oh, was it Canadian security or American security?
American. The Canadians would have confiscated them.
Really?
For sure. Absolutely.
Which part of Canada are you from?
I'm from a small town called Port Perry, Ontario. It's close to Toronto.
Oh, I've been to Toronto.
Yeah.
Yeah. But you don't call it Toronto. You call it Toronto.
Toronto?
Yeah, yeah.
Or the T-dot.
Yeah, the T-dot?
Yeah.
But you don't live there now, do you?
No, I live here.
Well, our barbecue system is completely different, of course, as you.
That's the first time I've ever seen that. That's crazy.
It seems perfectly natural. You use propane in Canada?
Yeah, we do. But... that barbecue still doesn't work, which is the weird thing.
Well, I think of you as being something of a style guru. That's kind of what you do, right?
Yeah, I'm a stylist, correct. Not a chef.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah. There's not a lot of barbecuing involved.
No.
You go, well, Cher, we thought we'd barbecue something and then look at your wing.
I would barbecue anything for Cher.
Have you ever... Now, is that very competitive in the stylist world to get the big, star names like Cher or Celine Dion?
Don't say her name.
That's right.
Are you allowed to say it?
I can say it.
Okay, yeah, fine.
Apparently, I'm allowed to yell, too, but anyone else does, and they're out the door.
I won't yell, I promise.
No, you're all right.
It is a little competitive. We're all kind of... but there's enough people to go around, definitely. A lot of women need dresses.
Yes, they do. Do you find yourself being hypercritical? I mean, I know that these shows where they really tear people apart on the red carpet and stuff like that. Are you very...
Am I hypercritical?
Yes.
No, the whole environment at Brad Goreski Incorporated is
very... very well done. Come on now, yeah.
Right? Yeah. Oh, thank you. Five people clapped. Yes. We're very celebratory there. So like when we find the right
dress... Does that mean you don't have sex?
No. That's different.
Oh, right, okay.
No, yeah. Well, we're kind of selling sex too. You know,
well,
I mean?
It's a kind of sexy thing, isn't it? You want to look, you want to have that oomph.
Exactly.
Oomph. So, yeah. No, the words. Oomph.
Yeah, that's why I put on this. I thought it was kind of sexy for tonight.
Yeah. You know what? It is. It is sexy.
Right?
You look great, and I think a well-cut suit is sexy.
Yeah.
Yes, it is.
It's better than.
I wish I had one.
You're wearing one.
It's all right. Yeah.
Yeah, I like that tie though.
Thank you very much indeed. Yeah, it's horizontal stripes. No, I thought I'd take a risk.
No, you did. It's nice. It's paying off.
Yeah.
Yeah, it kind of matches my shoes a little bit.
A little bit. Yeah. The only thing I think about the thin ties is they make you fatter, don't they?
Well.
Oh,
not
the fat,
you.
The fat makes you fatter?
that's kind of the rule, I think.
You're a big bow tie wearer, aren't you?
I am.
I couldn't do that.
Why?
Fat neck.
No.
Yeah.
No, you have a good neck.
No, terrible neck.
Really?
Yeah, very fat neck. If I put...
What if you wore a big bow tie like this?
You know what I'd look if I put a bow tie on? Like a prize pig.
I don't believe that.
That's true. People would be coming up and putting rosettes on me.
I'm going to send you a bow tie.
No, don't.
Why? You won't wear it?
Oh, I'll wear it if you send it, but I'd feel awful about it.
What if Celine Dion sent you a bow tie?
Do you know Celine Dion?
I wish.
Oh.
That's like a Canadian, that's like meeting the Queen in Canada.
She's like the Canadian Barbara Streisand, doesn't she, really?
Absolutely.
Right, yeah.
Remember when they did the duet together?
I don't want to talk about that. So who's your dream, do you have a dream kind of style icon that you'd love to really kind of put a dress on?
In the present tense, or
any time living, or
well, know. Marilyn Monroe is I've been obsessed with her since I was in like sixth grade. I actually did a school project on her in the eighth grade and made this like kind of scandalous video about her.
Really?
Yeah, it was just it was a very strange like homage to somebody. Hmm. Yeah, it was kind of sordid. Just a lot of scandalous information.
I think that's really healthy.
You do?
Yeah, why not?
I would love to. Marilyn Monroe, I think, is kind of the epitome of glamour. And, you know, but there's like, I grew up in the age of Madonna. Madonna's like the be all and end all for me. The 90s blonde. Yeah,
well,
the
90s Madonna. I mean, no, she's an English dude. Yeah.
My parents wouldn't let me go to her concert at the Sky Dome, and I'm still devastated from it. That was when I was 12, and I'm 34 now.
You don't seem that devastated. You're a confident, happy individual, aren't you?
There's that lurking, like, devastation on the inside.
Really?
Yeah.
Tears of a clown?
Yes, very much so.
Yeah, me too.
Crying on the inside.
Yes, yes.
That's what this and this covers up, the sadness. Not really. I'm just kidding.
No, I think really.
You do?
Yeah, why not? Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. It gives me a little bit of an edge, I think, if I'm a little bit more somber, like on the inside, as opposed to all, like, all the time.
I think you're probably a bit somber. You've got a darkness, I think.
A little bit. Well, all Canadians kind of do.
A little bit. In the winter months, they get a little bit.
Now you don't want to go to Canada.
You don't. No.
Stay away.
Do you find, as a Canadian, if I was to hand you a hockey stick, you'd lose your groggy mind?
I would lose my mind because I wouldn't know what to do with it.
Well,
I never played hockey.
You sure you're Canadian?
We used to have skating days at school, and the boys would wear hockey skates, and I wore like red velvet Elizabeth Manley figure skates. They were my sisters.
No, man. No, you should have. I think it's great that you did that. I really did.
Yeah.
God bless you.
Why not?
I think it's great.
You got to be who you are.
You know you do.
Yeah, you really do.
Yeah, because if you be someone else, then you're an idiot.
Basically.
Yeah
you're living
you're
a
gonna
lie.
Be, you're gonna be living a lie and not getting paid for it.
That's right. Wait. Yeah, right?
Maybe, I don't know. Hey, we're out of time. Very quickly, big cash prize, mouth organ, or what was the other one? Touch my glittery ball? What? Mouth organ, glittery ball, or awkward pause, yeah.
Let's do, did you say glittery ball?
Yeah.
Okay, let's do glittery ball.
All right, all you have to do is just, I'll turn it on and you touch it and we're out of here, all right?
That's what he said last night.
You ready?
Yeah.
Okay. Go away!
Oh, sorry, I'm excited.
Ready?
If you're watching Craig at home, you're missing half the fun. Consider this your formal invitation to laugh live in our studio audience at a taping of The Late Late Show with Craig Ferguson. Please give us a call at 323-570-0059 or visit our website at oneiota.com.
What did we learn on the show tonight, Craig?
We gotta go. We talked too long. Good night, everybody. Good night.